came back from England and I'd written some songs already, and I sat down and after meeting Eric and Xiaohan, and they gave me a few lessons on how to properly structure your songwriting, because I'd never actually done anything like that. I'd always just written it like how I felt. I didn't have like a certain structure. And once they taught me that, I was like, boom, boom, boom. Like, I wrote so many songs. So it was really fun. It was really exciting. I'm like inspired by so many different genres. Right. I kind of like, well, what I think are the best of each genre. So yeah, I listen to a lot of music. I listen to like pop, acoustic, which is what I'm really into right now, which is why I have my guitar music, dance, electronica, I even like death metal sometimes.
Really? Who?
Like Slipknot. And everyone's like, I can't believe you listen to this, you don't seem that type of person. I'm like, oh, I know. The biggest challenge would definitely be the diction. Even though I'm still learning Mandarin and I always find it hard to grasp the full meaning, because Xiaohan wrote some of the lyrics and her lyrics are so beautiful, but they were so complex. And I'd read them and be like, huh? Like, what is she talking about? So I had to get like the translation and be like, oh, okay. Yeah. But so that was really hard. But the diction, because when you sing, apparently it's different from when you talk.
Yeah.
Like, I might say xie, but when I sing, I have to be like xue.
Yeah, yeah.
So there was a bit of confusion between that. Eric and Xiaohan were in the studio with me. It was me and Jim, the producer.
Okay, yeah.
And what he'd do is he wouldn't have the lyrics of him. So only me, there'd only be me inside the studio with the lyrics.
Oh, okay.
And he'd like listen to see if like he understood everything I said. And sometimes he'd stop and be like, what did you say? Because he doesn't even know the lyrics. And I'd be like, sorry, I pronounced it wrong. So that was a bit pressurizing, but I got there in the end, so that's good. Like, I still don't know who I am. And I think that's the main problem that a lot of people my age have, where you feel like you should be turning into an adult, but you're not just quite there yet.
Okay.
Like, I still feel like a child, but like, I'm going off to university. Right. I have a friend who's married now and she's younger than me. And I was like, what is going on? So, it's really about, who knows, it's really about like discovering who you are and trying to deal with life's problems. So. This is, I'm very biased. I think I'm adventurous. I love trying new things.
Okay.
I'm very happy.
Okay.
I like being a happy person. Musical, hopefully, because I'm a singer.
Yeah, that might be.
Yeah, that might be helpful.
Yeah.
just a little bit.
Just a bit.
And what are the words? My friends say I'm cute, but I don't really think I'm. I like to think I'm more sophisticated. So.
Oh, okay.
And another word, colourful.
All right.
Yeah. I used to wakeboard and I used to think that was a really adventurous hobby because I used to like jump the wake quite high.
Right. Okay.
And I really want to do a lot of things. I want to go bungee jumping and I'll go skydiving if I got the opportunity. I know, everyone's like, what? I like go-karting. I just like trying a lot of new things.
Okay.
Like, it's not an adventurous in the terms of like adrenaline rush, although like I love roller coasters, like the highest roller coaster in England, it's so fun. And but I like I'm not afraid of trying new things. Like, if someone gives me a new piece of food that no one's gonna try, I'll try it because I want to like experience.
Okay.
And I love trying. I don't like things to always be the same.
Yeah.
Me just falling, singing my guitar, like strapped to someone like with a guitar.
Just to do the whole thing.
Yeah. I'll be like, oh look, I'm so adventurous.
Yeah.